Good afternoon, friends. This is Nagraj from HDFC Securities Retail Research, one of the technical research analysts. Today, we are going to learn about the basics of technicals and chart analysis. Friends, I'll tell you that technical analysis is like an ocean. With this kind of a one session or with a small kind of a in a webinar, we are not going to learn the whole concept of technical analysis. This is just a basic introduction touch of the technical analysis mainly for the traders or learners who want to learn the technical analysis and apply the theory into the market. We have some slideshow. We'll show you the slideshow. In between, I will detail about the technicals and all those things about. First, initially, we will start with the technical analysis and the fundamental, what it is, how we are going to start. The whole concept is just to learn. You have to learn the things. You have to learn again and again, read a book. We'll end up the session, we'll share some books. And finally, you'll getting some confidence to create a trading strategy. Only thing is about learning, applying the theory into the market and gaining confidence to create a trading strategy based on that technical analysis. That is our main motto. So friends, we'll start with the PPT. I'll show you. Yeah, this is basics of technicals and chart trading. The concept of technical and fundamental analysis. The concept of technical and fundamental analysis. We will describe about what is technical, what is fundamental, and how it differs. This shows the terms refers to two different stock picking methodologies and used for researching and forecasting the future growth of the trends. Both have their pluses and minuses. Both methods analysis have different approach to the same goal. Fundamental analysis study the everything from the overall economy, industry condition. Fundamental analysis is also evaluate the company's stocks, intrinsic value, and many factors like it looks like a financial data, industry trend, peer, competitor performance, economic outlook, and the fundamental. Even fundamental studies is the while the technical analyst studies. These are the two separate sets of study. I will brief you about what the fundamentals and what the technicals. Basically, fundamentals, we study the data, lots of data, companies, management, valuations, and even there are certain company factors are involved. And on the basis of that data, study of the data, we'll evaluate the market trend and we predict the market. But in technical analysis, friends, mainly based on the price action, volume. We derive many indicators from the price, open, high, low, close of the price, and from one by one patterns. From that, you can decide the trends and so many things you can learn over the next 30, 40 minutes. So now we'll discuss what are the benefits of using technical analysis. Technical analysis is able to tell you the entry and exit points, which is an important thing. It gives insight into a demand and supply situation. Volume trends also tell you the demand and supply. Technical analysis can be done on the commodity, any other chart. So what is the main benefit? What are the main benefits of the technicals? Like, as I told you, it will give you the insight over the entry and exit positions. How you can enter? Friends, let's take, you are a technical analyst. How it gives you a benefit of entering and exiting in the market. Let's take you are either a breakout trader, you want to create a trading position on the basis of breakout, or you want to create a trading position on the basis of support. Either you have to decide first. When the stock price comes down to the support, let's take it 100 is an example of the support, comes down to the support and shows some consolidation. Form some pattern, candlestick pattern, you'll come to know, yes, after the decline, whatever the time frame, it may be an intraday time frame, it may be a daily, weekly, the stock price is showing some consolidation, showing some bottom reversal, that is the time where you have to enter. means this with the pattern, with the analysis, with the theory, you'll get the entry point of the stock. At the time of the entry point, you will decide when I have to exit. Let's take, if you have purchased a stock at 100 rupees, you'll find at the higher levels at 106, 107 or 1010, there is a strong resistance. You have the things have been kept in the mind that you are going to sell at 107 to 110. Once it moves up to that 107, you'll see the stock price is showing some consolidation, some distribution type pattern. It may be around intraday time frame, or maybe a daily, weekly or monthly, whatever it is, you'll find it and you'll think it is better to exit. These are the entry and exit points based on the support buy. At the same time, it comes to a breakout buy. I told you a buy position, vice versa, it becomes to a sell position as well. When you are breakout, either a downside breakout, you are going for a sell position, or on a upside breakout, you are going on a buy position. Once it breakout sustains, you create a position. Let's take a breakout at 110 level, you create a position. You can place the stop loss at just below the support at 108 or 107. And wait for the target next set of resistance of around 100. These kind of scenario you will get only in technical analysis, not in fundamentals. Now, we'll go to the next slide. So, what are the downside of the technical analysis? I'm not saying any downside, bigger downside, but at times different indicators, tools give you a confusing contrary signal. Friends, if you go to any charting software, in the tool segment, you'll get 100 types of tools and indicators which are built in. Now the question is, which are the main important indicator, how to use the indicator properly? If you go on using all the 100 indicator for your one trading confirmation, you'll end up with confusing yourself whether to buy or not to buy, whether to sell or not to sell. Better, you can use it a few indicator which are really reliable to the market theory, which are showing a good backtest result for the underlying market, then you can use those indicators. But the small drawback of the technical analysis is, if you are using so many things, you'll be get confused, you won't be able to do a proper trading. And second downside, I'm not saying downside, but ignoring the fundamental analysis long term, wealth building becomes as difficult as the trend analysis is difficult to project. Friends, if you are a pure investor, you are looking for an investment for a longer term, let's take for 5 years, let's take for 10 years, then you can't create a strategy, investment strategy, only on basis of technical analysis. Because technical analysis, there are some people, there are with some techniques, they can create an investment strategy on basis of purely on the technicals. But if you use both the technicals and fundamentals, you'll get a better benefit, better insight of the stock picking or investment strategy. So here, on the basis of only on technical analysis, if you are going for a long-term investment, it may be a little skeptical, because ignoring fundamentals, if you are looking for a 10 years of period, if you are looking for a 5 years of period, fundamentals will come into picture. The whole fundamental scenario will decide the price trend of the stock. That is a small downside for this time being. So what are the downsides of the fundamental? This is not a relevant as compared to this topic, but if company incorrectly reports, the main thing is, as I told you, fundamental analysis is mainly a basis of a study of a data's evaluations, ratios, all those things. Everything is based on the company's performance data. If the data is manipulated, then the whole host of the analysis will go into difficulty, because you'll end up with the view of a wrong view. Either you'll be buying on the negative side or you'll be selling on the positive side. A stock can remain screaming for many years or even decades until they come. See, the fundamentals, that stock trend fundamentals, you cannot really create the labels for the buying. The thing is that if you go on fundamentals, it will give you confirmation after some period. When you look at the prices might have moved up substantially. So these are the some elements that you have to look after. If you are looking only on the fundamental basis, it will be very difficult to go on the stock picking. If you think a stock is too cheap, you are making a gamble that investors are something you can see. So fundamentals, if you're looking at the technicals, if the some stock is continuously trading in the downside, at some point of time, based on your valuations, fundamentals will tell you that stock is at the cheap. You'll end up with buying such stocks. But if you look at the technicals, the stock is still in a downtrend at most, declines further. So you'll end up with the losses or you'll hold the losing trade. How to benefit more out of fundamental analysis by technical analysis? Knowing to cut, it's a kind of a usage of both the theory at once to get a better synergy. So this is kind of a thing that knowing how to cut your losses, you can look at the cutting your losses by looking at the charts, or on the basis of fundamentals, if you have created a long position, investment long position, you can hedge your positions by creating a short position purely on the basis of technical charts. These are the some benefits more after the fundamental analysis by the technicals. Using technical analysis and fundamental analysis, so this is not a relevant subject, but tell you the plotting fundamental information. There are certain softwares that those plot price to book value ratio, price to earning ratio in a chart format. And you can use other things also in a chart format by tell you that which are the stocks where you can fundamentally and technically will be better positions to create a short position or a long positions. But these are not bigger, doesn't have any bigger significance in the trading arsenal. Now, friends, we will come into one of the important concept of Doe theory. So what is the Doe theory? Charles Doe is a founder of the Doe theory, and he has invented this theory. He said that market moves in a certain trend. There are certain characteristics that market moves. We say it as a Doe's theory. Charles Doe has said that there are certain things, we'll discuss one by one, there are certain things which can establish the trend of the stock, which can establish the strength of that trend, where you can really rely on the creating the trading strategy. We'll discuss here one by one what are the theory is all about. Doe's theory represents the idea of stock market behavior set out in a series of editorial. Wall Street Journal, you can see all those theories started at the beginning of 20th century. So what are the basics of the theory? What are the main important points of the theory? There are basically six basic tenets of the Doe theory. The average discounts everything. What is this average? See, whenever you see the certain events happening, what you see when events happens, the price will be discounted. Some positive is going to come into the stocks. Then the stock is at 100. From the 100, if the stock, some positive news is coming in the next 2-3 days, during these 2-3 days, the stock moves up from 100 to 120 rupees. When actually the news comes, even though it is the positive, irrespective of its positivity, the stock's price comes down. Means at the time when you look at the chart, the price discounts everything. Whatever the price you see, that discounts the fundamental factors. Within any uptrend that has a series of rising peaks and rising troughs, this is one interesting pattern. As a chartist, you must be knowing the higher tops and higher bottoms, higher lows and higher highs. When the stock moves, normally stock moves in a higher tops and higher lows, higher highs and higher lows, and during downtrend, it moves in a lower lows and lower highs. What does it mean actually? It means the stock price moves, the profit booking enters, shows some consolidation, finds the base at the higher level. Let's take an example of 100. From the 100, stocks moves up to 110. And it finds the resistance. It doesn't mean, technically, it doesn't mean that from 100 to stock moves up to 500 rupees. It doesn't happen in any other stocks. Sometimes it happens, but it's an extraordinary thing. Once it moves up to 110, the profit booking enters and the stocks corrects down to 105. Then the 105 becomes the base. And again, it moves up and it crosses the 110. In the whole scenario, 100 is the bottom, 110 is a higher top, and when it forms the base at 105 at the lower levels, it becomes a higher bottom. And once it crosses the previous high of 110, forms the next resistance at 115 or 118, that becomes a higher top. In the same way, the lower top, lower bottom happens. When the stock breaks below the support, makes a low, then the short covering happens and stock shows some upside momentum, upside correction, and forms a minor lower top, and again declines and moves below the previous low. The whole theory is same as I told you in the upside. The first bottom forms the lower bottom, then the next becomes, if let's take from 100 to 90, it forms a lower bottom. 90 is to short, from the short covering, it forms up to 96, 97. That 97 becomes a lower top. Once it breaks below the 90 at 85 levels, it becomes a new lower bottom. This is the theory all about. Major trends have three phases: accumulation, participation, and distribution. As I told you, the forms higher tops and higher bottoms, lower tops and lower bottoms. At the lower level, when the stocks places at the bottoms, it forms an accumulation, irrespective of a chart pattern, whether it's a 5-minute chart, whether it's a 15-minute chart, whether it's a 20-minute chart, whatever it is, whether it's a daily chart, weekly chart, or it's a yearly chart, that over the at the lower level, once it form, the stock forms a bottom, that is the accumulation phase. Once it breaks out from the accumulation phase, that theory comes into a participation phase. Once it participation at the higher level, as I told you, when the stocks forms a higher top, it shifts into a distribution phase, where the stock enters into a corrective mode, shows a decline. The average must confirm each other, and an important trend change requires to confirming the same thing. The same here average they have mentioned for a Dow Jones industrial average. Whenever the stock price moves, unless it reverses, unless it shows the reversal, it has been presumed that previous underlying trend remains in force. Once the upmove starts, unless we see some reversal pattern and confirmation of the reversal pattern at the highs, we say the continuation of the uptrend. Once it reverses from the downtrend, we say the reversal pattern. Volume must confirm the trend. Volume is a very important thing where it confirms the trend, where you can see. When you see the prices moving up with the rise in volume, it's a clear indication of a long buildup. You must have heard about it. Even though, as the same way the price, stock price declines with a rising volume, it means that the people are going heavily short, means heavily supply is there in that particular stock. So what you have to do, you are going to create a short position when there is a rise in volume and a downtrend in the stock. When there is a rise in volume and an uptrend in the stock, you create a long position. And the vice versa, when there is a rise in price, lower volume, it shows the short covering, all those things. So friends, now we'll come into the next elements of the technical analysis is chart pattern, types of charts. You must have heard about the charts. There are different types of charts which are being created from the price itself. By using the price, the charts have been created. Chart is a main arsenal, main weapon for the technical analyst. There are certain charts, there are certain theories, techniques, how to use the charts. So we'll see the types of charts in the PPT. We can see the bar chart. The bar chart has open, high, low, close. So charts, for any type of charts, we use the four elements of the price value: open, high, low, and close. In this OHLC chart, you can see it's a simple bar. In the side, beside the small, another one chart is there where you can see a single line with a small levels at the left side and the right side. Single line is a range, and here is the open, and the right left side is the open. Upper shadow is a high, lower shadow is a low, and right side is a close. This is the type of chart. Now go on to the next type of chart, which is a line chart. Single line that contains the stock. What you can see here is a single line, just line connecting one to one. This is just a closing price, taken as a closing price, and a chart has been created. types of charts. Japanese candlestick chart, so one of the important chart candle formations in the technical analysis is a Japanese candlestick chart. I'll just give you some insight about the Japanese. People, you know why, friends, people call as Japanese chart, not any other, they do not take any other country's name. Because this candlestick terminology has been started in Japan in 1700. There was a feudal system. People were using this candle. Why we call it as a candle? It looks like a candle, normal candle and a wick. This candlestick terminology has been started in Japan since 1700, and it was introduced to our Western world in 1950, 1960, when since then it has been a very useful method of technology in the technical arsenal over the period of time. This is important. Most technical analysts use this candlestick chart. This chart gives you a insight of the health of the underlying. So chart called a Japanese candlestick chart style. It is similar to a bar chart. Like what you can see here, red and green, two candles. So in the candle, green candle is a candle where the closing price is above the opening price, and the red candle is a candle where a day's closing price is the below the open price. Visually, you can easily grasp the red is a green is a positive one, and red is a negative one. You can easily grasp or visible that can be made. So you can, friends, you can see high, low, same as line chart, as I told you, close, open. Here also in the red chart, open, high, low, close, which is visually, graphically shows very good indication so that you can easily understand the health of the market. This is a chart how it constructs. When it constructs, here we have used green and blue and red candles. Same, the blue candle, the blue color forms the same role as the green color. Blue is a positive candle and red is a negative candle. How the chart, see the single, you can see the candlestick charts over here. You can see higher highs, higher tops, period of charts of any time. If you can see intraday chart, 1 minute, 5 minute, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, 1 hour, or a daily chart, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, whatever you can see, you'll see the charts like similar kind of a charts. Now, after the chart, we will see what is the trend. We have already discussed the trend. We know that what is uptrend, what is downtrend, how to identify the uptrend and downtrend. We have two charts over here, the pattern of gradual change in the condition on an average general tendency of a data points move in a certain direction. If the prices move in a certain direction, that establishes a trend. Here we can see the trend by using the support line, downtrend using the resistance line. This is the graphics of the trend, where you can see a downtrend, sideways trend, and uptrend. Downtrend means the stock price is continuously moving down. Uptrend, the vice versa, stock price is continuously moving up. Sideways trend means moving in a range. Importance of volume. Friends, in a technical analysis, volume and price are the most important factors. So how the prices forms the theory, in the same way the volume theory also helps to create a better trading strategy. Importance of volume. Volumes denote the total trading activity in a particular period. The rising volumes with the rise in the price are the uptrending periods. Rising volumes with a decline in price is a downtrending period. Both are indicative of strength of the direction, either it is an uptrend or it's a downtrend. Whenever you create a strategy, buy long positions with a rise in volume is a healthy trading strategy on a long, and a rise in volume with the downtrend in the stock price is a healthy trading strategy on the downside. Support and resistance. In the last webinar, we have discussed about the support. Support is the area where certain levels, the data points continuously reacts. Let's take the stock price breaks the resistance of 100, comes down to the lower levels of 100. That 100 becomes the valuation support. if the stock price again holds the support of 100, that means the 100 becomes the valuation area, that becomes a strong support zone. Here you can see it in a chart. What is happening here is a trend line. We have drawn the trend line connecting two points. Drawing the trend line means you have to have one point connecting the drawing, completing the another, we want another point at completing the trend line just to connect trend line. When trend line increases, whenever the stock price in future or in current price, the supports the line, it becomes a support line. In same way, resistance line. Resistance line is the area, a supply zone. Let's take the example from the 100 to stock price moves up to 100, 110. 110 becomes a resistance zone where the selling pressure overrides the buying pressure, where the supply is greater than the buying. That becomes a resistance line. You can see it here. You can draw even how you have drawn support line for the uptrending channel. The same way in the downtrending market, you can draw a resistance line connecting the highs. The longer the period time frame, the price trades support or resistance area, the significant area becomes. As I told you, when the valuation area forms, if the prices test that valuation area successfully and bounce up, that area becomes a very strong, very strong, very strong. That is the area. First, you have to establish all these things. You have to keep in mind when you are creating a positions. You have to see what is the strong support, what is the strong resistance. When the stocks comes down to the support, when shows some consolidation, that is the area where you have to create a long positions. At the same time, when the stock price forms a resistance and shows some negative pattern at the resistance, that is the area where you have to create a short positions. So these resistance supports becomes very important while creating a trading. Support and resistance role reversal. What is role reversal? Here I can tell you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's take one is a 100. From 120 stocks comes down to the 100, shows the support, takes the support, moves up to the 115, 5 rupees above, and comes down, breaks below the 100 level and forms the low of 80. From the 80, again the support emerges, buying emerges, shows the upside and finds the previous 100 resistance. Here, what is role reversal? Means the previous 100 area, the number one, what has been written number one becomes, let's say example, it's a 100, that becomes resistance. Initially, it was a support. After breaking below the support, it has changed its role to the resistance. Same vice versa. Once the resistance has been broken on the upper side, when the price retests at upper level at number four, it becomes a support. It changes its role. That's the role reversal. There's some more charts of supports and resistance, where you can see here, you can see the stock price after moving up, again reaches to the support level, and here when breaks below the support, that downside area becomes a resistance. Now let's move on to a moving average. It's a simple techniques. Moving average itself says the popular one of the popular versatile tools indicator using, because it's simplicity, we use a widespread. Moving average is the average. If you take a 10 period moving average, every 10 period will come into the picture and the prices will be added to the 10 period. You'll see some label curvy lines as a moving average. Moving average is an average of a certain set of data, normally drawn based on the price of the stocks on the basis of the period of the moving average. Moving average is a trend following method. It never anticipates. We'll see the short term moving average sensitivity to the price action. We will see the moving average charts of the moving average later. Simple moving average. There are certain types of moving average. Simple and exponential. Normally people use a simple moving average is a simple for a calculation, and exponential is a more mathematical formula involved in it. These are the, you can see the charts of the moving average. In the chart, these are the moving average. One, they use exponential, one simple moving average side by side. See how the prices are continuously taking support at the moving average. You can see it. Once the moving average has been broken on the lower side, the stock price declines subsequently substantially and moves up by taking moving average. So what is going to be the important factor in the moving average is a creation of strategy, either buying or selling strategy based on the moving average support and resistance. What you have to do, if you go to any charting software, you get the number of moving averages. Even from all the time period, you can see. The famous one of the important time period is 200-day simple moving average. But I don't see any particular moving average which has a tendency of weightage on the particular stock price. Because first, you have to find, you have to check out from your side which moving average fits fine for the stock price. For let's take a for Reliance, you want to create a long positions in the Reliance. You just have to plot a moving average. Just check out whether 10 period moving average, you know, if you are on the daily chart, whether 10 period, 20 period, 30 period, 50 period, 200 day, 50 day, 100 day, which moving average fits fine for the Reliance. Once you find, let's take the example of 50-day moving average, you found the 50-day moving average is very good showing support and resistance line for the stock price, for the Reliance indices. Then you can see, whenever the stock price moves above the moving average, you have to create a buy position, long positions, keeping a stop loss below the moving average and wait until the next moving average lines declines. Here it has happened, like it moved up, until here you can create a long position. Once it breaks below this moving average, exit the moving average. The entry is exited. The position is squared off. The same way when you are in a short, when the stock price moves below the support of the moving average, you can create a stock short position on the stocks, place a stop loss above the moving average and ride the trend until it reaches to the next level of that moving average. Another concept is the Bollinger Bands. Friends, Bollinger Band is invented by John Bollinger. His Bollinger Band is nothing, just a middle, we have a 20 period, the moving average, and the ranges of the stock price above and below the 20 period. Means it's a two standard deviation. They have created a formula. They have said that within a 20 period moving average, they give a ranges of a two standard deviation, means upper side 1 ST and lower side 1 ST. Means upper side they have given some range, lower side they have given some range, they become a band. Middle band is a 20 day moving average, and upper band is the upper Bollinger band, lower band is the lower Bollinger band. And trading strategy is that whenever the stock price moves above from a middle band, that is the support where you have to create. When it reaches the upper band, it's a signal of some resistance. It doesn't mean that trend reversal, signal of some resistance. There is some profit booking. You have to be alert. You have to exit your long positions. At the same way, once it breaks below the middle band, you have to create a short position. And when it reaches to the lower band, you have to exit your short positions. Like that, you have to trade in a Bollinger band. Friends, now the technical analysis, what it is all about. We have given, you can note it down, the suggested reading. Yeah. That means in a technical analysis, learning itself is not done. The whole thing is that you have to make money in the market. What is the purpose of learning? Technical analysis. You want to become an analyst, want to become a trader, you have to earn the money from the financial market, wherever it is, whatever it is, whatever it is, asset class, maybe a commodity, maybe a currency, maybe an equity, derivative, whatever it is, you have to learn. How it works out? First, you have to learn, you have to understand the theory, you have to backtest it, apply it to the real market, you'll gain the confidence, create a strategy. This whole cycle becomes completed. Now you are in an early stage. Now you are learning. Since I am also learning, since first is like a oceans, never the learning never ends in technical analysis. Every time you'll see some new insights. What we mean to say, you have to learn. First, you have to, when you understand it, you have to apply it in a real market. See, friends, in a technical analysis, whatever patterns we have has been formed, we will discuss the pattern in our next webinar, which is connected to this webinar, and which is a very, very important concept of the next webinar, is the patterns. We will continue with the patterns. I'll tell you about when you understand the concept of technical analysis, when you find the patterns which is forming. See, these patterns, these technical analysis have been invented. The people have been using this technical analysis since past many decades. And the patterns have worked those period. It is still working and is going to work in future as well. The only thing is that what you have to do, you have to learn the concept. You have to understand the concept. You have to apply it to the real market. You have to backtest it, gain confidence, and create strategy based on the patterns. For learning the technical analysis, understanding the technical analysis, this 30 minutes, yeah, 40 minutes webinar is not at all going to enough. You have to read. For reading, there are so many authors. They have written a very, very good books in the technical analysis. You can write it down, this one. These are the suggested readings. These books are available in the bookstores. These books are even available in the Google also, in the net also, you can search it. These are the very good books. You can read it, read, and you'll understand the concept. You'll become a good chartist. So these are the certain readings, Beyond Candlesticks, Steve Nissen, Japanese Candlestick Charting Techniques, Steve Nissen. He's the one person who invented the candlestick terminology. He has written very beautifully about the candlestick patterns in these books. You do have to read it. And the next book is Charting Explained, Martin Pring, Bollinger. I discussed about the Bollinger, the John Bollinger who has created the Bollinger bands, John Murphy, Douglas, W.D. Gann. So many authors have created beautiful books on the technical analysis. So you have to read it. And the only thing is that you have to learn. So you're not going to learn with the one thing, one shot or one day. This you have to keep on reading. And we will continue to discuss with this kind of a webinar. Our main aim is to help you to learn the technical, learn the concept, charting technology, and charting and learn to create a strategy. By learning it, by applying it properly in the market, you can create a trading strategy. You can gain money from the market by properly investing your precious money. So friends, we will conclude today's webinar. I hope you understood it, and stay up tuned for our next upcoming webinars. We will communicate with you, and thank you. Thanks a lot.